Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Muhammad Sheikh's channel. Please click the bell icon so that you may receive timely notifications of our upcoming videos.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace and blessings to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. I seek refuge with Allah from the shaitan, the stone. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. With the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Today's topic is what Al-Quran says about Ahlul Kitab, translated as the people of the book. In the general understanding of the world, so-called label Muslims, and in general understanding of the world, this Ahlul Kitab, the people of the book, are referred as Jews and Christians. That's the general understanding among the society, or which we've been hearing from our childhood, that the people of the book are the Jews and the Christian. So today we are going to analyze the verses of the Quranic ayat referring to the Ahlul Kitab or the people of the book. And you will come to know the behavior of the people of the book. And by the behavior, we will understand, are they Jews and Christians or someone else? Because I will be directly speaking on those ayahs. Before the people of the book should be discussed, we should know what the book is. Because when you say people of the book, they refer to the Jews and Christian Bible. I brought this Bible also. They say people of the book, meaning the Jews and Christians, referring to the Bible. And then they say that this Bible is the book revealed before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and reveal Quran before the book of Allah. So first of all, we have to understand what is the book in the Quran. The book Quran is an Arabic word which is generally not translated, and I've not also translated. Quran means the reading comes from the root letter qara. And there's a command in the Quran, اِقْرَى بِسْمِ رَبِّكَ الَّذِي خَلَقْ, which means read in the name of your Lord who created. So this qara, from this root letter, the Quran is derived, and it is referred as the reading. The meaning of Quran is the reading. And the Arabic al-kitab, translated as the book. So first of all, we will come to know what book we are talking about and to whom this book was given firsthand, and how this people of, what are the personalities or described of the people of the book. But first of all, we have to understand what the book is. So I will be dealing those verses which are referring first about the book. Then we will discuss the people of the book. And before I discuss, I would like to tell you something. This book, because I've read it, I'm just giving you on my own understanding of the book. This book contains many words describing the book itself. And if you open the booklet, on the first page, I've written down certain names. And these certain names, you are mostly aware of these certain names, but not know exactly what these refer to. For example, the first page, the number one is the Quran that is mentioned, Surah Al-Baqarah 2185, which means the reading, the word Quran. The second word is a Torah, which is mentioned Surah 5, Maidah 5 and Ayah 44. Translated as the law. Torah in Arabic translated in English is the law. We must know the meaning, because if you just say Quran, we don't know the meaning. Quran means the reading. The Torah means the law. Al-Injil. You've been hearing from your childhood, Injil, or translated as Gospel, which does not give you the meaning. Gospel, Injil, you don't know the meaning. But once you know the meaning, it means good news. Injil means good news. Zabur. We think it's a book referred in the Bible as Psalms. But if you look, the meaning Zabur means the peace. Al-Furqan is a criterion. The criterion, its meaning, Furqan. Burhan, the proof. Sultan, the authority. Al-Hikmah, the wisdom. Hidayah, the guidance. Nazil, revelation. Wahi, inspiration. Kalam, the speech or the word. Basair, insight. Ayat, signs or verses. Al-Majid, glorious. Ajib, amazing. An-Nur, the light. Ahsan al-Hadith, the beautiful narration or incident. Ahsan al-Qasas, the most beautiful relationship. Al-Amthal, the examples. Al-Mawla, Maw'idah, sermon. Al-Dhikr, the remembrance. Al-Wah, the tablets. Dhiya'un, the shine. Bayyinat, clarifications. Risalat, the messages. Al-Anba, the good news or the prophecies. Al-Qawl, the saying. Suhuf, the pages. Sharia, the way. Al-Amrillah, the order of Allah. Al-Haq, the truth. Al-Ilm, the knowledge. And maybe some other words also, I have not come, because there are many other words. But if you are listening to these words, why I was reading it, I'm trying to emphasize one point here. These words have mentioned in the Quran, and the references are there, and now not one or two times, many number of times. And these are the qualities or the attributes of this book of I hold in my hand, the book of Allah. Like Allah is the name of Allah, the God. But Allah is described in the Quran by 99 above attributes or the names of Allah. They are not 99 gods. They are 99 names, qualities, or the attributes of Allah. So we Muslims do not say that there are 99 gods. We say Allah is the name, proper noun, the God, translated as, and the other names are Al-Jabbar, Al-Rahim, most gracious, Al-Rahman, Al-Wudud, most loving. So these are the qualities of Allah. By virtue we understand this is what Allah is. Similarly, this book of Allah contains these names. These names I read to you, these names are the qualities of the book. If you say, where are the ayats? It's in the book. What is the law? It's the Torah in the book. If you say, what is the authority? The Sultan is in the book. Where is the guidance? Hidayah is in the book. Where is the Furqan? The criterion is in the book. So what I'm referring to, these are the above 33 attributes or the names of the book, explaining the book. They are not 33 books. They are not 33 books, but there is one book of Allah with above 33 attributes. Similarly, there is one Allah with above 199 attributes, the names. So this is basically I was referring to why I read these names. Now we will read the ayahs. First of all, we'll understand what the book is. In Surah Yunus 10 and Ayah 37, page number 3. Okay. Surah Yunus 10 and Ayah 37. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ أَن يُفْتَرَى مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ
ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل الكتاب لا ريب فيه من رب العالمين.
And this Al-Quran, the reading is not that can be produced from other than Allah, but it is a confirmation that is between His two hands and a detail of Al-Kitab, the book. There is no doubt in it from the Lord of the worlds.
If you look in the ayat, in the Arabic text, you see Quran and Al-Kitab in the same ayah. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. You see the Quran in Arabic? In the fourth portion is the وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ. The same ayat contains the Quran and Al-Kitab, the book. So if you know the meaning, then you can understand what is being said. The Quran is the reading. I am reading the book of Allah. This is in my hand, I hold, is the book of Allah, written down on a paper at the moment. Anything that is written down is meaning Al-Kitab, the book. And Quran is the reading of that book. So Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. And this Quran, this reading is not that can be produced from other than Allah. Nobody can produce the Quran.
وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. But is a confirmation which is between your two hands. So when I'm reading, you can confirm that I'm reading the Quran that I'm reading, you can confirm which is between your two hands, being the book you're holding. The book contains the ayahs, and you can confirm that this is a confirmation what this gentleman is reciting. So this reading, Quran, is not وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. And this Quran is not, and يُفْتَرَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ, is not that can be produced from other than Allah. وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. And it is a confirmation which is between his two hands. وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ. And the detail of Al-Kitab. When you read, Quran means reading, when you read, the detail of the Kitab you come to know. If you will not read, you will not come to know what is detail, what does the book contains. So when you read, you come to know the detail of Al-Kitab. La rayba fihi min rabbil alameen. And there is no doubt in it from the Lord of the worlds. So in this ayah, we have come to know the difference between the Quran in its meaning, but actually it is the same. Reading of an ayah of the written one is the Quran, and what you hold in your hand is the book. So Allah has used both these terminologies in the book. When you refer to the book, it refers to this book. And when it refers to the Quran, it refers to the reading. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. Ramzan is the month in which the Quran is sent down, the reading is sent down, not the book. Not the book, Quran is reading. You hear in the Tarabi the reading of the Quran. It is being recited and read. And you listen to the reading. It's not the book. Book is, I hold it written down on a piece of paper. Anything written down is the book. So first of all, we have to clear our mind. The book, when I say, is referred to this book written down on a piece of paper or this I hold in my hands or which you hold in your hands. Now we will see in the further ayahs to whom this book was given. To whom this book was given. Generally we know, all of us, it was given to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the messenger of Allah. We know this. But we see what the Quran, the internal evidence, describes to whom this book was given. In the then we'll come to the family of the book, the people of the book. But what this book was given to whom? I will read this ayahs. You count down, you focus the names that will come in these ayahs. This ayahs that I'm going to read refers to the prophets mentioned the Quran. These names of the prophets, this is the only place the maximum number of the prophets are mentioned in this ayahs. Except for one name, and that is Idris in Surah 17, Surah 1956. Surah Maryam 1956, a prophet Idris is mentioned separately. But
Otherwise, all the prophets, if you include that, these names I'm going to read, you'll find in here. The names of the prophet are mentioned in the whole book Quran at one place are these, the names of the prophets. So I will read this ayah, you can count these names. Al-An'am 6, ayah 83, 84, 85. وَتِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا آتَيْنَاهَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتٍ مَّنْ نَشَاءُ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ كُلًّا هَدَيْنَا وَنُوحًا هَدَيْنَا مِن قَبْلُ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّةِ دَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ وَأَيُّوبَ وَيُوسُفَ وَمُوسَى وَهَارُونَ وَكَذَلِكَ نَزَّلَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ وَزَكَرِيَّا ويحيى وعيسى وإلياس كل من الصالحين. In continuation, next page, Surah Al-An'am 6, 86 and 87 and 89. وإسماعيل واليسع ويونس ولوطا وكلا فضل الله على العالمين ومن آبائهم وذرياتهم وإخوانهم واجتبيناهم وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم أولئك الذين آتيناهم الكتاب والحكم والنبوة فإن يكفر بها هؤلاء فقد وكلنا بها قوما ليسوا بها بكافرين. Now I will read the translation, and the most important point that we have to derive from these verses that are in continuation is the book and the names of the prophets. We have to analyze, because we have been hearing from my childhood that there are four books given to various prophets. For example, Musa salam got the Torah. That's the from hearsay. What Isa salam got the Injil. You've been hearing this. Zabur was given to Dawud alayhi salam. You've been hearing this. And Quran to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these four are the attributes or the names of the book. I've already discussed this before. But in this ayat, you will see the names are mentioned. And then you see what happens. And I'm reading from 83, 84 and 85, the translation. And that was our reasoning that we gave to Ibrahim to use over his people. We raise the grace to whom we will. Surely your Lord is full of wisdom and knowledge. In this ayah, you have to focus the name of the Prophet. And the name of the Prophet is one Ibrahim al-Islam. In the Quran, if you can note down, in the Quran, the name of Ibrahim al-Islam is mentioned 69 times. His name is mentioned in the Quran 69 times. And with the name, it describes the environment of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the how he delivered the message, what was going on in his era, in his time factor. So Ibrahim is described with the name Ibrahim alayhi salam, is mentioned in the Quran by name 16 some number of times, and description of his what the message was he was given and what happened when he was just delivering the message. Further it says وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ. And for him we granted Ishaq and Yaqub. Two more names. Ibrahim, you can count in your mind. Ibrahim al-Islam is the first, and now the word is name is Ishaq al-Islam and Yaqub al-Islam. Ishaq al-Islam is mentioned 17 times, and the narration with him is mentioned 17 times. And by Yaqub al-Islam is mentioned in the Quran 16 times. So now three prophets' names you can count. Kullan hadayna, we guided all. And from before we guided Nuh, and from his offsprings we guided Dawood and Sulaiman and Ayyub and Yusuf and Musa and Harun, and likewise we reward those who do good. So in this verse you will see Nuh alayhi salam is the fourth prophet, counting fourth. Dawood alayhi salam is five, Sulaiman alayhi salam is six, Ayyub alayhi salam is seven, Yusuf alayhi salam is eight, and Musa and Harun, 10. Okay, 9 and 10. I'm just describing the names of the prophets. And Zechariah and Yahya and Isa and Elias, all from those who correct themselves. 10 and 4, 14. And the next page, 86, Ayah, and Ismail, and Yasa, and Yunus, and Lut, all were those to whom we favored over the worlds. How many names? 18 names. And one I mentioned is mentioned Surah Maryam 19, Surah and Ayah 56, and that is Idris. So you can count how many names? 19 names. 18 mentioned here in the whole book Quran, the names of the prophets. I will read further. And from their fathers and ancestors, and from their offsprings, and from their brothers, we selected them, and we guided them to the straight path. These prophets, we know by name, from their fathers, ancestors, and from their offsprings, and from their brethren, Allah says, we selected them, and we guided them to the straight path. Now is the key factor to understand, the most important point that I'm going to highlight here. That these are they, 1989, they are those to whom we gave Al-Kitab, the book, and Al-Hukum, the government, and Nubuwah, the Nubuwah means the prophecy. So if they reject with it, so without doubt, we will advocate the people who will not be the rejectors with it. So you all have seen in the verses that there are 19 names mentioned by name are the prophets, and to all these prophets is given ulaika alladhina atainahumul kitab. To all of them the book was given, al-kitab, the book, al-hukum, the government, al-nabuwa, the prophecies. So what you've been hearing, you see the Isa Islam name was mentioned here. So Musa Islam name was mentioned here. Okay. Dawud Islam name was mentioned here. And Suleiman. But Muhammad Islam name is not here. Because all these prophets was revealed to Muhammad Islam. And further, I will give you the further ayat. You just turn now, then we come back. Al-Ma'idah 5 and ayah 40, 48. وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ فَاعْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ عَمَّا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. And we have revealed the book to you in truth, which confirms from the book that is between his two hands and a watcher guarding over it. So govern between them with what Allah has revealed, and about the truth do not follow their desire that has come to you. So now 18 names are mentioned, 19 names I have referred to, and here it says we have revealed to you, referring to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the book. Which book? No, hold on. Which book? 19 prophets. The previous we have just read, ulaik, if you look at them, you see they will not, you will not find any difference. Ulaik alladhin atainamul kitab is the 19 prophets. Ulaik alladhin atainamul kitab wal hukum wal nubuwa. Same book was given to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is not an iota of difference of a comma. No difference. We are making the differences. We mean the whole Muslim and Christian Jews world. This is our prophet and that is your prophet. The Jews say Moses is our prophet, and they say the Christians say Christian Isa Islam is our prophet and your prophet is Muhammad. What about Dawud Islam and his people? Huh? Where are the people of Dawud Islam and his people if you want to make these divisions? This division is not, it is the Quran. If you read the Quran, Allah is, because it's the book of Allah. Allah created the heavens and the earth, and he will give one book or different books. Does it make sense to you? Allah is one with attributes of 100. His book is one with attributes of 33 or maybe more. And he's given to all the prophets the same book, and giving to you, to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the same book. And we have got the same book in our hands. We'll see all this, but at the moment you have to understand that here we have read clearly and distinctly the names of the Prophet. And with all these names, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَهُمُ الْكِتَابِ وَالْحُكُمُ وَالنَّبُوَّةِ, these are the names to whom we gave Al-Kitab, the book, Al-Hukum, the government, and An-Nabuwa, the prophecies. The Nubuwat was the same, Kitab was the same, and Hukum was the same, no difference. And to you, we have revealed to you the book and the truth. Which book? Same book. Same book, no difference. Containing all, everything. The Torah is in it, the Injil is in it, the Quran, the word is in it, the Burhan is in it, the Sultan, the authority is. Nazil, the revelation is in it, Wahi, the inspiration is in it, the word of God is in it. Whatever you want to say, it's in the book. It's all total Allah's book. And why would Allah give different books to different people and create confusions? Allah is perfect, His book is perfect. And He sent prophets who were perfect. The book was given to all the prophets, we read it. So now we will say how this book is given to people. So Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 2, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ. It doesn't say Quran, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِي هُدَى الْمُتَّقِينَ. That is the book, no doubt in it. A guidance to those who guard. So in Arabic, هذا means this, basic Arabic. هذا means this, this book. And ذَلِكَ means that book. Can anyone tell me why Allah is using Dalikal Kitab, that is the book which does not have a doubt? Why didn't say this is the book which does not have a doubt? Anybody from the audience? Why Allah is saying that is the book that does not have a doubt? Referring to that book coming in ancient time. That is why it didn't say Hada. It said Dalika, that is the book. So if you look in the Urdu translation, they say Ye wo kitab hai. Ye wo. It should be wo in Urdu and English that. So normally these translations are, it is Dalika, they translate this is the book. Where in the actual, it is that is the book coming from time. That is the book that doesn't have a doubt coming from the Lord of the worlds. Referring to time, fact of Ba'id, Ishara-i Ba'id, referring to far off distance. Anyway, it says that that is the book. Again, the word is Al-Kitab. All the ayahs that I read up to now, you'll find the word Al-Kitab in the Arabic. So now we read, this, that is the book that does not have a doubt. So that book does not have a doubt, a guidance to those who guard. Those people who are muttaqeen, who guard themselves, it's a guidance. So I'm asking you, if you ask anybody, which book is this Allah is referring to? All these scholars in one breath, they will say Quran.